Alrighty, guys, we will go ahead and get started. We're so glad you guys were able to join us this morning as we talk about building cultural recognition and appreciation for both our working learners and just our coworkers and other people in general. So I'm excited to announce that we have Abby Anderson with us. So I'll go ahead and turn the time over to her.
Thank you, Calissa. Calissa, before I do get started, are we recording this session to share it with others?
Yes, ma'am.
Awesome. Okay. So again, thank you all for joining us this morning. Before we do get started, I want to acknowledge that this presentation was put together by our colleagues in the Leadership and Workforce Development. Unfortunately, Kristen Young is unable to attend this morning, but I'm happy to share the information with you all. So again, just to set the stage a little bit, with the topic today, I want to just note the fact that we need to recognize that we love ourselves through others. And the way that we learn to love ourselves is through other people and the relationships that we have with them. Because as human beings, we are literally designed to learn, grow, and love through other people. Again, we are tribal creatures. We are not meant to do life alone. So just keeping that in our minds, as we're walking through this session today.
All right, just to give you a little preview of what today's look is going to look like, we're going to start by talking about what recognition is and why it's important. Then we're going to go through a couple of strategies, ways that you can start working on it. And of course, we want to also note a couple of the things that you can do to avoid it going wrong. And finally, we're going to give you some resources so that you can put this into practice so we don't just give you all this information and leave you hanging. And then we'll talk about working on recognition year round, not just once a year.
Okay, so again, what is recognition and why is it important? Of course, we all know what recognition is, but why is it important? So I am going to pose this as a question to you all in the audience. Why should we be spending time being at this workshop? Why is recognition important? And feel free, you can come off mute or throw your answer in the chat if you would like. But why is recognition important?
Hey Abby, I wanted to chime in with an answer here, if that's okay.
Yeah, absolutely. Thank you.
So I think recognition is important for probably some of the same reasons you were saying before. That's part of the human condition. We like to have a sense of belonging, and we like to know that our recog that we bring value to the experiences that we're living in. And you know, if somebody feels recognized for the work they're doing, they're more likely to feel more fulfilled and continue to contribute.
Absolutely, Toby. Absolutely. Thank you for that. And before I get on to the next slide, just want to give anybody else a chance to add anything if they had anything to add to that. But absolutely, Toby. That's exactly where we're going with this.
We have a couple in the chat that I'll just read out for everyone. We have that it keeps employees motivated to do their best. Everybody wants to feel validated. It helps us see our value while we're at work, and also it acknowledges others' unique contributions or traits that they offer.
Absolutely. All right. So moving on, throughout the last 60 years, researchers have been studying what truly motivates employees. So obviously, yes, we need to make money because we all have bills to pay, right? But what truly motivates you? And the list I'm about to show you all is from a study done by Dr. Donald Clifton. And is in his book, How Full Is Your Bucket? But here are the top 10 reasonings that folks say motivates them to continue to work and work hard at that. So one thing I want to point out here is, does anybody see what the top answer is from the study? Appreciation. Appreciation is the number one thing that is motivating people in this study to work hard and motivate them to go to work, right? One thing I want to note too is look at where wages is at on that list. Wages is number five. That's halfway down the list of what's motivating folks to really work hard. So, just putting that in perspective, if you have a great supervisor that is continually showing appreciation towards you as an employee, you might be more inclined to stay in that position, even if you know, like, dang, I could be making more money if I were to go elsewhere. Again, just wanting to kind of highlight that. So with that in mind, I know I was shocked when I first saw that, but kind of, I was like, oh, I guess that makes sense, because I was able to reflect and think of some different positions of my own that I knew I wasn't being appreciated to the extent that I felt I should have been. So is that true with anybody else? Are there any of you that would be comfortable to say that you've left a place of employment because maybe appreciation, you weren't being appreciated enough?
I would say, Abby, my job before I came to ASU, I was making more when I first started than when I first started here, and I was also receiving yearly bonuses.
Mm-hmm.
But the treatment from management and not being appreciated made me take less money and go.
So, Athena, so. You're a perfect example, right? You were in a position where you were making more, and you left to go to a position where maybe you were going to get that appreciation and recognition a little bit more of, like, hey, Athena, we see the work you're doing. Thank you for that.
Exactly.
Yeah, absolutely. That was a great example. So again, just wanted to note that recognition is one of the most important things that you can do to increase retention at your unit, both for professional staff and for our working learners, right? And to lower that turnover. So again, why is it important? It's really just about showing your employees and giving them the respect that they deserve. It's about showing them that you notice and appreciate all of the hard work that they are doing for you, your team, your unit, whatever the case may be. So if you see working learners aren't getting along, for instance, you could start by showing more appreciation towards them. That positive attitude alone can help improve their mindset a little bit, and may also help them feel better about coming into work. Again, creating that positive environment and creating a space that your students or professional staff members are wanting to come to this place, right? One thing I want to note specific to our student employees is we all know that our working learners are not making a ton of money. That is a known fact about student employment, education at large, right? So if we can't match those wages outside of ASU, so I'm thinking the last time I went to In-N-Out, I think there was a sign on their window that said, you know, starting out wages, $17 an hour. Like, holy cow, yeah, why wouldn't I want to go work at In-N-Out and make $17 an hour versus being on campus and making $12, maybe $14 an hour, right? So again, can't match those wages, but we can show them appreciation and recognition and show them that we value their time and work. And again, especially for you all, that are utilizing Work Plus in your student employment positions, we're also showing the students, you know, it's more than just a paycheck. You are building valuable skills here, and this is how it can translate to your future position. So again, we have to find not necessarily the money that we can pay the students, but what are other ways that we're able to quote unquote pay these students, right? And recognizing and appreciating the students and the work that they're doing is one huge step that we can take there. Because let's face it, recognized employees are happy employees. And again, happy employees are creating that positive work environment for us to come to. So again, this is looking at a study from Forbes. Forbes has listed three reasons why employee recognition really matters. So again, that first one, recognized employees are happy employees. Again, good vibes in the office are going to translate to a happier employee, which will then also translate to a happier home life, and so on and so forth, right? So again, just keeping that positive attitude, especially in front of the student employees, is a good, great starting point. The second one here, appreciative leaders are appreciated leaders. You'd be surprised by the degree to which a simple thank you to your employees will foster an atmosphere of trust within your employees. When employees are knowing that their efforts that they are putting forth are contributing to a cause and are noticed by people higher up in the food chain, if you will, they will feel a deeper connection, A, to the work that they're doing, but also B, to that leadership and the team as a whole that they are on. And then again, lastly, that third point, when employees feel recognized, they're going to stick around. So just to further look at that, consider the costs of training a brand new employee, right? To the point where they are now able to work as confidently and as efficiently as maybe a company veteran or that person that just left your unit. Training takes on a time from everybody, but then of course also money, because you know, if they're having to be on the clock to do different trainings versus on the clock doing work and tasks for you, right? So just keeping that in mind too, and again, tying back into that retention rate within our spaces. So all of this to say, if you're sitting there thinking, okay, Abby, but where do I even start? Where, how do I do this with my students, right? The first part to it would be to take the time to actually see and identify an opportunity to praise someone, to praise your working learner, right? And then after you've identified an opportunity, then the second part of that is to actually follow through and that physical acknowledgement and showing them or thanking them for the work. So just to give an example here, before we here at WorkPlus hired a graphic designer, one of my communication specialist working learners had stepped up and started creating more visuals for us to use on our website, for us to use in our program documents, used by students and staff, and of course, social media. She just one day stepped up and started making these different graphics for us. So in one of my one-on-ones with her, I had mentioned to her, you know, like, hey, I see that you're stepping up and creating these graphics for us. And they were fabulous, like way better than I would have been able to do with my creative brain that I really don't have. But then also, you know, I didn't have the time to put together quality graphics like that. So again, just telling her, hey, I see what you're doing and thank you so much for doing that. She was like shocked to hear that. She was surprised, because she didn't realize that she was doing that high quality of work. She thought she was just, you know, here's something just to get us by until something else can be made type thing. But after having that discussion and me saying like, hey, not only do I see the work you're doing, but you know, the program director, Scott, is also seeing the work that you're doing and is impressed by that. After having that talk with her and expressing that I see that in her, it was very apparent that she was taking more pride in her work. And she was excited to be doing those different pieces and sharing those new designs with me. So that's just a quick example that I can share with you all. Does anybody else have an example of a time that maybe you showed that intentional appreciation to your student, or maybe even thinking now as we're giving these examples, can you think of a time coming up that you're like, ooh, that might be a great time that I could highlight and thank that student? And again, feel free to come off mute, throw it in the chat. Again, just identifying different opportunities for us to say thank you and show that. I always feel like these Zoom silences are always so long. So that was long enough for me. I'm going to go ahead and move on to the next slide. But if anybody does have an example that you'd like to share, again, feel free to throw that in the chat or come off mute as we're moving into this next slide. So one way to really think and give specific examples and not just a blank praise that you can all start with is utilizing the ABCs of the individual. So their attitude, behaviors, and contributions. That's just a quick way to start. So again, what was their attitude? Do they have a positive attitude even though they're doing, you know, auditing some reports for you, which is not always the most fun thing to do, but if they have that positive attitude. Their behaviors, again, just they're showcasing those positive behaviors in your workplace. And then the contributions, again, just giving a specific example. So not just a, hey, Calissa, good job today, but finding a specific like, oh, hey, Calissa, you facilitated the workshop and you did a great job. Like, finding that specific example, right? Not just a blanket, generic, great job today. Again, just keeping those ABCs in mind. And I know we have a worksheet that we're going to be sharing here in just a second, that Calissa, if maybe needed at the end, we can send a follow-up email, and we can also include some of these other tips like the ABCs and things like that, if that's something everybody would like. But just to continue on here, there are three different types of recognition that you can really start with, because again, it might be a little overwhelming. Where do I even begin? So here are just a few suggestions for you. The first one being just day-to-day recognition, right? This could, should be just the foundation of your strategy as you're starting or trying to be more intentional with recognition. Again, just verbal praises, e-cards or Sun Awards if you want, just for those more day-to-day things. Moving forward, you could also start looking at above and beyond. If your student, let me think of an example real fast. One of our working learners brought it to our attention. She said, hey, why aren't we tabling to get the Work Plus name out there more? And so she researched what it takes to table and took it upon herself to go ahead and register that tabling, working with Calissa to make sure dates work appropriately. But she ran with that and got a date scheduled for us. So like that is a great example of above and beyond. You saw something that you saw there might be an issue, not enough people know about Work Plus. How can we change that? So she took that initiative to help us get Work Plus the name out there more. And then the last one, the milestones. To me, honestly, other than day-to-day thank yous, milestones might be one of the easiest ways to start, because this one's quite simple. You could start by inserting reminders in your calendars of work date anniversaries. If you have a student, you know, who is coming back for a second semester, or they are celebrating, they've been with your unit for a year, that is a huge milestone that, and an easy one that you can pull to recognize and just show the student like, hey, we value having you on our team. Thank you for being here with us for a full year, or thank you for coming back for a second semester, you know? Of course, too, as we're approaching graduation, I have a working learner who's graduating this May. I put it on my calendar. If I'm able to go to that ceremony, I would love to go to the ceremony, but if not, the least I can do is make sure I have a card for him and say, congratulations, you've done it, right? Little things like that. Of course, too, how many of you know that National Student Employee Appreciation Week is coming up, right? We should all be knowing that that's coming up here April 10th through the 14th. We can do something intentional for our working learners during that week, right? So different things like that, thinking of those milestones. Looking to, there's a gentleman, Dr. Bob Nelson. He's kind of considered the expert in recognition. He has a book, The 3001 Ways to Recognize Employees. And this is pulled from that book there. So when performing the art of recognition, it's important to follow what he calls ASAP cubed. So as we can see here, the first one, do it soon. Timing is everything, right? So again, don't wait until the performance evaluation time to recognize. If you're a unit that does, you know, at the end of every semester, you are having that more formal performance evaluation with your student, you shouldn't wait until the end of the semester to say, oh, hey, in January, you worked on this project and you did great back then. We should be showing them that recognition right as soon as it happened. Again, you shouldn't start with a, hey, Calissa, 3 weeks ago, you did really well at this, but I forgot to tell you because, you know, life got crazy. That's taking away from the actual appreciation that you have for them. The second one, as you see there, sincere. Do it because you are truly appreciative that whatever happened, you are actually appreciative. A quick example that I can think of, you know, don't just tell somebody, I'll use one of my working learners wearing a Work Plus t-shirt, right? I'm not going to go up to her and say, hey, I love your t-shirt just because it's a Work Plus t-shirt, right? I should tell her I like her shirt because I truly care about the shirt, not just because I feel like she's going to like that I'm acknowledging she's wearing a Work Plus shirt at work, right? So silly things like that, but again, make sure it's sincere, because if not, your student or colleague may read right through that. Specific, again, just be specific and give details about the achievement or example that you're thanking them on. The personal one could be a bit tricky, because some people may prefer receiving recognition in a written form or email form. They don't want to have that physical contact or be looking you in the eye type thing. Some people just don't enjoy that, right? So again, knowing how your working learner or colleague likes to be recognized is a big step too. And I know we from the Work Plus office have shared with all of the Work Plus supervisors some different tools, one being a recognize worksheet, and we're going to get into that here in just a second. But utilizing different tools like that, again, just to fully understand how individuals like to be recognized. I know personally, there was one time a student that she actually was interning with me, I knew her birthday was coming up, so I stopped at the store and I got her a cute little vase with flowers and a happy birthday balloon. I thought she would love it, right? Who doesn't love flowers and balloons on your birthday? This student, that's who. She was so mortified that I did that, because then she had to walk across campus with this balloon and flower, and then that was telling everybody it was her birthday, and that was just drawing attention on her that she did not like. So that's kind of a form of recognition that kind of went wrong, because I didn't know what her form was. So knowing their personal preferences there. Keep it as positive as possible. Do not mix in criticism. That's a big no-no when showing appreciation or recognition. Has anybody had somebody try to show you appreciation, but they're mixing in some criticism? And if so, would you feel comfortable sharing an example?
I can share one, Abby.
Oh, thanks, Calissa.
I had a past boss who always started every conversation by saying something good that I'd done, something well, or it had gone well, whatever. But that was always followed by that very classic, but this could have gone better, and this and this. And so even though it was making a note of something that I'd done well, it was immediately taken away from, because I was then focused on the criticism and how I could do better.
So, and like you just said, right? Sure, she just told me I did something well, but now my brain is stuck on, I can be better, this is what I messed up on, right? So just keeping that in mind, how would you feel if somebody gave you that recognition in that sense? So again, just keeping in mind the fact that we have to love others to love ourselves, and knowing how that's going to perceive to others. And last, be as proactive as possible. Do not wait for a perfect performance, because quite frankly, you could be waiting a very long time. So just be proactive, and again, intentionally start seeking out those opportunities or the tasks that your working learners or again colleagues may be showcasing that you can point out. Again, if you're looking at just the do it as soon as possible and just that verbal phrase, could take a whole 20 seconds out of your day to do, right? So just trying to be more intentional about that recognition and showing our students, working learners, the appreciation. Ooh, and Vicky, I just saw you had thrown in the chat your example as well with AISSS, but absolutely. Moving on to our next activity. Calissa, do you mind sharing in the chat the worksheet? So again, this is the worksheet that we have shared with you all, and hoping maybe you've had a chance to share it with your working learners. But I am going to ask us to take like 2 or 3 minutes here, and I would like you to look through this worksheet on your own and answer it for yourself. And then if I have any examples or volunteers that would feel comfortable, to share a little bit about what are ways that you personally, based off this worksheet, would like to be recognized, or again, there's the link for you to share with your working learners if you haven't had a chance yet to get your working learners to fill this out so that you know how to appropriately show them appreciation throughout the school year. So again, I'm going to give everybody about 2 minutes here to kind of go through and fill this out on your own, and then we'll meet back in just a few seconds. And just for me to go back on that awkward silence, I'm trying to play music, but of course my music just shut down. So I'll try to get some music in there in just a second. Okay, hopefully that was enough time to give you a chance to go through that worksheet and kind of answer it for yourself. Do I have a volunteer of somebody that would like to mention just maybe one or two things, again, for you personally to be recognized and appreciated? Any volunteers?
I'll go, Abby.
Right. Thanks, Miss Keeley.
I'm like hiding behind my camera. So I don't like public recognition. I don't like to be in the spotlight. I like to be just told one-on-one. I don't have to be told in front of a group. And what else did you want me to say?
No, that's totally fine. I just wanted you to share like two things off that sheet. So yeah, as you mentioned, Keeley, it's good to know that as Keeley's one of my colleagues, I should know that Keeley doesn't like that public recognition, so I shouldn't shout her out in front of everybody at one of our all-team staff meetings, right? So
thanks, Abby.
I know now that I'll just go to Keeley one-on-one and say, hey, Keeley, by the way. So any other examples or volunteers would like to share how you like to be recognized? Thank you for sharing, Keeley.
Hey, Abby, I'd like to share. It's actually something that you mentioned earlier, making sure that your recognition is sincere. I think it kind of goes along with that. I want to be recognized for things that I think are good and valuable. So if I'm recognized for something that is just kind of, I know it was a mediocre job or I know I can do better, that's not rewarding for me. It really has to be something where I put in my effort and I earned the recognition.
Absolutely. And kind of going off of that too, it's, you know, one of those where it's like, I felt like I did a great job and now nobody is saying, hey, that was a good job. So it's like, how do I
exactly
ask for that as an employee? How do I ask my supervisor, like, so was that a good job? Do you have any feedback? Could I improve? But yeah, so that's a great point too, Toby, is just knowing and understanding the person that you're talking to and maybe knowing their capabilities in the sense of like, for you speaking, Toby, you knew that you could have done better, but maybe as your coworker, I wasn't aware of that, but how do we have those conversations with each other and making sure that we understand where each other lies? So that's also a great point, Tony. Thank you. Any other examples? Awesome.
Awesome. So we just want to give you a couple of different ideas as you're going into this. National Student Employee Appreciation Week is actually just 2 weeks away. So some of these are great to like get your mind running as you're preparing for that. And of course, we also have a handout that we'll give you at the end of this presentation that gives you some additional ideas and templates. But just to kick it off, a really great way is just to say thank you. It doesn't cost anything. And it is very effective at showing that you do appreciate your working learners, right? Another one is an ABCD card. I'd never heard of this before, but this is just an above the call of duty. If you notice that your coworker or your working learner does something that maybe isn't necessarily what they have been asked to do, and it's something above and beyond, that's a great thing to just note. Hey, you did a really great job with this. And it can just be like, even just like a little post-it note. I know that I have a couple of those from current jobs and other jobs that I just, it's just nice to look back and go, oh, someone did appreciate me, right? Then when it comes to our working learners, another great thing is just being flexible with their schedule. Maybe you give them a couple of extra minutes for lunch or another break during the day, noticing what they need. And then especially with college students, but in effect, everyone loves food, right? Food is a great way to show appreciation. And then a couple of different technology ways. You can do LinkedIn recommendations, social media shout outs, writing them an email for the college or department that you're in. Those are really great, especially as we're helping our students build up their LinkedIn profiles. Having those recommendations on there is a great way to have for them to show future employers that they were recognized at other jobs. And then also just like if you're at a staff meeting, just recognize the work that they're doing. And of course, the last one I think is a big one, especially I know that I appreciate it both as a working learner and as a professional staff now. It's providing opportunity for them to do more work and go above and beyond and take on more challenging projects and things that interest and excite them. Those are all ways that don't necessarily cost you more money or take a lot of your time, but show that you're appreciated. And of course, there's a ton of other things in addition to that that you can work through.
And I just also, I want to highlight and note on the sense of the LinkedIn recommendation. As Calissa said, as our working learners are trying to further develop and grow their LinkedIn profiles and their network, it's one thing to keep in mind, especially if you have any working learners that may be graduating soon. So I know, again, I mentioned that I have a student who is graduating this May. And our last one-on-one, I asked him, I said, hey, would that be something that you would benefit from? Would you like me to put a recommendation on your LinkedIn profile as a previous supervisor? Here's what I see. And he was like, oh my gosh, yeah, you could. Well, then from that, I developed a recommendation and how I would have worded it. But then I met with him again before I went ahead and posted that because he knows what he's wanting to get into for his career better than I do, right? So I sent him, I said, here's what I would like to say about you. How can we make sure that this is best worded for your industry? And did I highlight the things that you would want to be highlighted, right? So again, taking those things into consideration, and ultimately, again, we are all here to help build the career readiness within our working learners and help them be as prepared as they can be for their workforce as they're graduating from ASU. So just keeping that in mind. And that also is just going back to the sense of like, get to know your working learners, because they are more than just a body to do those tasks, right? They are a human, they have goals themselves. So just taking that little bit of time to really get to know who is working with you and working on your team, that in its own is showing the student that you care and appreciate them, right? So just my little add to that part with the LinkedIn recommendations. So again, as Calissa had mentioned at the very beginning, recognition can go wrong. I don't want to spend too much time on this because of course we want to highlight the positives of it and the positive ways to recognize. But again, want to address this. So of course, assuming that you know what motivates everyone and how they like to be recognized is going to lead to recognition going wrong. So again, taking into consideration my example, I thought the student would love flowers and a balloon, and boy was I wrong. So don't ever assume that you just know what is going to motivate and what people are going to enjoy. Recognizing late, you're letting it grow stale. So again, we should be showing that recognition and appreciation as soon as we can. I understand that maybe if your unit or your team had a big event and you couldn't say thank you to everybody right there in that moment, but try not to let it go more than like a day. Again, I know if your event ran late that night and you don't want to sit and try to type up emails, just try to get it done again within like the 24-hour period of when it happened. Not having a process can kind of go wrong. So again, one thing that I mentioned and something that I like to do, I like to have different milestones on my calendar to help me remember. That's just one of the little processes that I have to make sure that I'm keeping recognition and appreciation towards my working learners efficient and fair towards all of them. Try to steer away from any type of statements or recognition that's going to just come off as generic. Again, as we've mentioned throughout today's session and Toby's mentioned personally, it can come off generic. So be as sincere as possible. Again, try to find those specific examples to highlight for your working learners or colleagues. The manager takes credit. Don't take credit for something as you're trying to show appreciation and recognition. And then lastly, criticize publicly. Again, you shouldn't try to criticize at all while trying to give appreciation and recognition. Try to just keep that as positive as possible. Because again, if we do any of these listed items here, then again, it's going to come off as half-heartedly, and that's just not what we want, right? Our colleagues and our working learners are going to see right through that. Did want to share with you all some resources that ASU at large has for all of us. So Calissa just threw in the chat there the link to ASU's Appreciation Hub. So if you weren't aware, ASU does have this Appreciation Hub. So if you click on that link, this is what it's going to, or it'll bring you to like the homepage for it. But you can click on the e-cards option and it'll bring you to a site that looks like this. So again, this is just a hub full of blank e-cards that we can select from. So of course, you see the happy anniversaries, happy birthday, congratulations, there's that above and beyond. But again, just knowing that we can use these for our colleagues, you'll see some in there. I think there's some like for wedding announcements, baby announcements. So things like that. Again, if you're wanting to get specific and personal, again, just make sure that you know and understand how the recipient would like to receive that. But I wanted to make sure you all were aware of this option.
And then as we're going through, like Abby said, it's a good thing to like put milestones on your calendar or other things like that. But some other fun ways to just keep the recognition going year round is to talk about some like national days. One of my favorite things is every morning I come in and I write down the national holidays, and there are some weird ones out there, but there's also a lot that focus on recognition. So as you can see on that list there, this is a perfect list to just go in and add that to your calendar. Then on that day, that's a great way to just go in and say, oh, it's International Thank You Day. Maybe I'm going to go around and say, be more intentional about saying thank you to my employees and coworkers, or just because they are, it's 27. I'm going to go around and I'm going to bring everyone just a little gift because why not, right? So those are just some fun ways. In addition to that, I know a lot of people, well, not a lot of people, but a good way to do that is just have a goal to give out a Sun Award. Maybe even if it's just once a month, put it on your calendar. I'm going to sit down for half an hour and write down a little Sun Award for someone that month. And it can be one of your working learners, it can be one of your coworkers, your supervisor, whatever, but that's a great way to show appreciation. And I think you'll realize that when you show appreciation, appreciation tends to come back to you too, which is also beneficial. And so while we do want to keep this going year round, we do want to specifically make a note that National Student Employee Appreciation Week is 2 weeks away. It is April 9th through the 14th. You should have received already, but I just shared again with you. This is just a little PDF of some ideas that you can use to celebrate your working learner during this week. It's got a couple templates for thank you cards and certificates of appreciations, candygrams, memes, everything you can think of. There's coloring pages. But just remember, there's so many ways to appreciate your working learners. And if you have the time, have them fill out that that form. See how they want to be recognized so that you can show that you do recognize and appreciate them as much as you already do, because they do add so much to our university.
Thank you, Calista. So again, just to show this, Calista did throw that link in the chat for you all to access this document. But here at the program office, we have developed this guide, if you will, for, as Calista just mentioned, different resources and templates for you all to utilize within your own offices once National Student Employee Appreciation Week does come, quickly approaching. But wanted to again make sure you all had access to this. If for whatever reason you do not have access and can't get to any of those templates, please do not hesitate to contact either Calista or I directly. Throw it in the supervisor Slack channel, whatever the case may be. We'll make sure that you can access that. With that being said, we are at the end of our session today. I wanted to leave some time for any questions or comments, if you had any comments. Otherwise, thank you all so much for joining us today. And again, we look forward to seeing what you all do for your working learners coming up here in the next couple of weeks. If you do have any type of events or share on social media during National Student Employee Appreciation Week, please tag us. We would love to see what you're doing with your working learners. We'd love to share with others just to highlight, again, all of the work and great things that our working learners are doing for us. Thank you all. And Calista, I'm not sure, did you have anything else you wanted to add?
Nope. We'd love to see what you're doing for your working learners, but otherwise, thanks for coming.
And before I do say my final goodbye, just a quick reminder that we do have our end of the year celebration coming up, Calista, on April 12th?
April 12th from 11 to 1.
And that is an in-person event here on the Tempe campus. I'll be sending out more information to all of you supervisors, but we would love to have you join us in person as well in April. Thank you all so much.